Hi everyone, I am R.V. Kiran, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering. In this video lecture, I am going to explain a small topic, and the topic to be delivered is the two types of construction methods used in the ellipse. So we have already seen about four methods in the previous lectures, and in this lecture I am going to explain about the construction of ellipse by using rhombus method and directrix focus method. And this directrix focus method is also called as general method also, and it has also other name eccentricity method also. So there can be different names for these methods. So generally they are called as general method in the engineering drawing, and directrix focus method is also other name. So these are the two methods I am going to explain in this video lecture. First method is the rhombus method in the ellipse. So we have seen different methods in the earlier lectures, that is oblong method by using a rectangle, and the parallelogram method by using a parallelogram, and arcs of circles method and concentric circles method. And this rhombus method is a method used by construction of an ellipse by using a rhombus. So this ellipse has been inscribed in a rhombus. So first of all, we are going to read the question for the rhombus method. Draw a rhombus of 110 mm and 80 mm long diagonals and inscribe an ellipse in it. So this is the basic question. Basic question for the construction of an ellipse in a rhombus. So in the rhombus there are two diagonals, one on the vertical side, one on the horizontal side. So one of the diagonal is larger than the other diagonal. So in the earlier lectures we have seen different methods in the oblong method as well as parallelogram method and arcs of circles method, concentric circles method. There are two types of lines drawn. First one is the horizontal line, second one is the vertical line. So the horizontal line is somewhat larger than the vertical line. So in the engineering drawing language we called it as major axis and minor axis, but in the rhombus we called it as diagonals, that is the large diagonal and the small diagonal. So here two measurements have been given for the length of the diagonals. So 110 mm and 80 mm are the two measurements given. So first of all, we are going to draw the horizontal line with 110 mm measurement. So I had drawn a 110 mm length line from the center of it. I have drawn another line of 80 mm length, same as the major axis and minor axis. Then connect all the points of the all the end points. So there we can get a rhombus there. So from connecting all these end points, there we can get a rhombus there. So this is the shape of the rhombus with the measurements of diagonals length 110 mm and 80 mm respectively. So this is the first step we are going to draw. We are going to construct an ellipse in a rhombus method. So first of all, we are going to construct a rhombus. So this is a rhombus here. Then from each side we have to identify the center of the rhombus. So there are four sides and two diagonals. So leave the diagonals here, only we have to find the centers of the sides only. So this is the center of the left side, top side, and there are four centers for four sides and name it as ABCD. So in the previous lectures and in the previous methods we have named the major axis and minor axis, but here we are naming only it for the centers of the sides only. Then connect the diagonal ends to A and B. So connect the lower end of the diagonal, that is vertical diagonal, and connect it to the points A and B. Next, on the same side and the other end of the diagonal, that is vertical diagonal, connect it to the C and D points. So this is the procedure. First of all, we are going to connect the A and B points with the lower end of the vertical diagonal, and next we are going to connect the C and D points with the upper side of the vertical diagonals. So there we can get these lines there. Then mark the intersection points on the long diagonal, that is horizontal diagonals, and name those points as 3 and 4 and the vertical line points as 1 and 2. So these are the four points we can get by the intersection of two lines. So first of all, we are going to connect the A and B points with the lower end of the vertical diagonal and C and D points with the upper end of the vertical diagonal. So there we can get the 1, 2 and 3, 4 points here. With 1A as radius, so take 1 and A as radius and 1 as center, draw an arc AB. So take 1A as radius and 1 as center, draw an arc AB. Then from the similar position from 2, so take 2D as center, take 2D as length, 2 as center, draw an arc CD. This is the two arcs we have obtained from the centers 1 and 2. First of all, we are going to draw the AB arc, that is taking 1A as length and 1 as center, draw an arc AB. Then taking 2D as length and 2 as center, draw an arc CD with the help of compass. So we are had drawing with these arcs with the compass only, AB and CD arcs. Then taking 3A as radius, so taking 3 point and A as radius, draw an arc AD. So taking 3A as radius and 3 as center, draw an arc AD and go to the other end, that is 4 point. So take 4B as length and 4 as center, draw an arc BC. So there we can get AD and BC curves by using compass. So these are the four curves with four different points, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So the centers are 1, 2, 3 and 4, but the lengths of the arcs are 1A, 2D, 3A, 4B. So we can take other ends also, 1B, 2C, 3D, 4C. So we can take any end regarding to our purpose. So this is the obtained ellipse in the rhombus. So these are the construction steps we are going to obtain ellipse in a by using a rhombus method. And this is the procedure for the rhombus method. So first of all, we are going to draw rhombus of given dimensions, that is the long diagonal as well as the small diagonal. Then marks the midpoints of all sides and name them as AB, CD. So there are four sides for the rhombus and the centers of and the centers or midpoints. So the midpoints of the sides can be determined and it is named as ABCD. And join these points to the ends of smaller diagonals. So mark it as 1, 2, 3 and 4 as 4 centers. And taking 1 as center and 1A as radius, draw an arc AB. Then taking similar position, that is take 2 as center and draw an arc CD. Similarly, taking 3 and 4 as centers and draw 3D radius, draw arcs DA and BC. So then we can get the ellipse in a rhombus. So this is the simple procedure for obtaining an ellipse in a rhombus by using rhombus method. So this is the simple way of drawing an ellipse in the rhombus method when they are giving a diagonals. So two diagonals, 110 mm and 80 mm long diagonals. And next method is the directrix focus method, and it we can also call it as general method. So they are called as a general method also, and eccentricity method also we can call it. So first of all, we are going to study the problem. Point F is 50 mm from a line AB. A point P is moving in a plane such that ratio of its distances from F and the line AB remains constant. Then eccentricity is 2 by 3. Draw locus of the point P. So this is the given question, and the question given is somewhat differed from the previous questions, that is in the previous methods. This question is somewhat different from the other methods, and this method is also different from the previous methods, and this is the general method we called as. So this general method is obtained in the parabola and hyperbola curves also. So there is a general method in the parabola as well as hyperbola curves also. So in this, a directrix and a focus line is obtained. So first of all, we are going to draw a directrix AB. So directrix means a vertical line projected in the end. So name it as AB. So this directrix line is of length, we can take any length. So based upon the purpose of drawing sheet and space of the drawing sheet, we can draw the any length of this directrix. Next, taking the midpoint of the line, draw a line of 50 mm length from this AB line. So from the center of the AB line, draw a perpendicular line to this directrix which is of 50 mm length. So this is the directrix line, and mark it as F, that is focus. So we can draw a long line, and from the midpoint of the directrix line we take a 50 mm length, and the 50 mm length from the directrix line is marked as F, that is the focus point. Next, divide these focus points into 5 equal parts. So what is the purpose of dividing these 5 equal parts? So all the students have been a question that why we are dividing these 5 equal parts. So there in the question, the eccentricity is given as 2 by 3. So what is the total parts of the eccentricity means 2 plus 3. So 2 plus 3 means 5. So we are going to divide these line into 5 equal parts. So when they are giving it as 1 by 2, we are going to divide it as 3 equal parts. So 1 plus 2 means 3 equal parts. So the eccentricity is given as 2 by 3 here. So we are going to divide it as 5 equal parts. 2 plus 3 means 5 equal parts. Then we are going to mark a vertex point. So name it as V. So eccentricity is 2 by 3. So that is the second part from the focus line. So this is the second part from the focus side and third part from the directrix line. So that is the meaning of eccentricity. Eccentricity 2 by 3 means mark the vertex point as second point from the focus line, that is second part from the focus line and third part from the directrix line. So if it is given as 3 by 2, but the eccentricity for ellipse is E is less than 1, so that is we are going to take it as less than 1 only. So if the eccentricity is 3 by 4, that is less than 1, we mark it as third part. So the focus, the vertex point is third part from the focus line and fourth part from the directrix line. So here the eccentricity is 2 by 3. We are marking it as second part from the focus and third part from the directrix. So this is the vortex V. Then mark another points also from the vertex. So take any distances. So we are taking a 45 mm distance that from the directrix line and 15 mm distance from the vertex line, and draw another vertical lines also taking any lengths. So now take the length from the vertex V to the first point, which is the first vertical line. So take the length from V to the first vertical length line and take F as center. So we are taking focus as center for all these arcs and cut an arc on the first vertical line. So we are taking the first vertical length, line length from the vertex. So we are drawing, cutting an arc on the first vertical line only from the center F. So that is 30 mm length. Then draw another two points also. So similar, from the similar positions, draw these points also from V. So taking length from the vertex line, so these are the similar points we can get from the drawn from the focus. So as well as on the lower side of the focus line also, we get the similar points as well as the similar as the upward points. So draw these points. So draw a curve from these points and V as centers. From the V we can draw the arc. So this is the locus of the point P and we call it as ellipse. So by constructing other points also from the other end, so this is the vertex from the first end and we can draw it on the other end also by completing on ellipse. So this is the construction of an ellipse by using the general method also. So first of all, we are going to recognize it as what is the eccentricity. So 2 by 3 is the given eccentricity, and what are the construction steps. So first of all, we are going to draw the directrix line, that is AB line of any length, and mark a midpoint on the directrix line, draw the focus line on it and take 50 mm as length. So point F. In the question there is given that point F is 50 mm from a line AB. So we can take it as 50 mm from the midpoint of the directrix line to the focus point. So then divide the focus line into 5 equal parts, because the eccentricity is given as 2/3. So 2 plus 3 means 5 equal parts. So we are making 5 equal parts on it, and mark the second point from the focus as vertex. So mark the second left side point of the second left side part of the focus as vertex point and name it as V. So it is the third part from the directrix line also. Then draw any length of taking any length as lines and draw a vertical lines on it from the vertex line, and taking V and the vertical lines as length from the center focus, draw an arc on it by connecting all the arcs that is obtained from the vertical lines from V. There is an arc obtained from it. So this is a closed curve. So when we draw more points, we can get the end of the ellipse. That is the closed end of the ellipse. So this is the basic construction of the general method, and this is the procedure for the general method. So first of all, we are going to draw a vertical line AB, that is the directrix, and point 50 mm from it. So point F is taken 50 mm from the directrix line, and divide 50 mm distance in 5 equal parts. So these 50 mm distance is divided into 5 equal parts, and name second part from F as V. So that is the left side part, second left side part as V, that is vertex, and it is 20 mm and 30 mm from the focus and AB line, that is directrix line respectively. It is the first point given ratio of distances from F and AB, that is 2.3 and 20/30 mm. So form more points given same ratio, such as 30/45, 40/60, 50/75, etc. So these are the points taken, and taking 45, 60, 75 mm distances from the AB line. So that is the distance from the AB line, and 15, 20, 25 mm distances are the from the vertex line. So draw these three vertical lines to the right side of the vertex. Now with 30, 40 and 50 mm distances in compass, cut these lines above and below with F as center. So cutting these lines as F as center, join these points through V in the smooth curve. So V is the center of this curve, and we are going to draw the connect the vertex point from all those points, and this is the required locus of the point P. So therefore we can get an ellipse by drawing more points on it. So when we draw the more points, we can get an ellipse, that is the closed curve. So but for the general method for parabola and hyperbola, there are open curves. So the parabola and hyperbola are open curves, so there is no need of drawing more points there. But in the ellipse, we can draw more similar points in the construction, and we have to close the arc. That is, ellipse is a closed curve, and we are going to draw more points in the and more vertical lines in the focus line. So by drawing more vertical lines in the focus line, we are obtaining more points on it. There is a closed curve in that point regarding the parabola and hyperbola are open curves. So this is the general procedure for the general method. We call it as directrix and focus method, and it can also be called as eccentricity method. So in the exam purpose, the three methods have been equally visualized, that is directrix focus method, eccentricity method, or general method. So the paper setter can give any one of the three names in these methods. So we are going to, the student have to know all the three names of these method, that is general method, eccentricity method, directrix focus method. So this is the procedure, and thank you. So this is the, these are all the six methods we have discussed in the previous three lectures. In the next lectures we are going to explain the parabola and hyperbola models also, and these are the end for the ellipse models. Thank you.